Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah, Quran Weekly. This is Abdul Nasser Jangda coming back to you with another episode yet of the stories of the prophets. Today we're going to talk about Yusuf alayhis salam. Yes, the famous, amazing story of Yusuf alayhis salam. The story that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself calls Ahsanul Qasas, the best, the most excellent of stories. Yusuf alayhis salam is basically being put in a position where he is being called, he is being asked to commit a terrible, terrible sin, and he is being enticed towards this sin. So what does Yusuf alayhis salam do? Yusuf alayhis salam obviously backs away from that situation, but he goes a step beyond that. He says to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rabbi, my Lord, my Master, who guided me to this wise decision, asijnu ahabbu ilayya mimma yad'unani ilayhi, that I would rather choose prison than committing the sin that these people are asking me to commit, adultery, fornication. I would rather go to prison than do that. وَإِلَّا تَصْرِفْ عَنِّي كَيْدَهُنَّ أَصْبُ إِلَيْهِنَّ وَأَكُمْ مِنَ الْجَاهِلِينَ. And oh Allah, if you don't save me from them, I fear that I might actually fall into that sin and commit an act of ignorance. فَاسْتَجَابَ لَهُ رَبُّهُ فَصَرَفَ عَنْهُ كَيْدَهُنَّ إِنَّهُ هُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Allah answered Yusuf alayhi salam's prayer and saved him from their, trickery and everything that they were planning. And he is constantly listening and all-knowing. ثُمَّ بَدَى لَهُمْ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا رَأَوُوا الْآيَاتِ لَيَسْجُنُنَّهُ حَتَّى حِينٍ. And then basically Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it apparent to him that you will serve some time in prison. But Yusuf alayhi salam understood that that was what was best for him at this time. وَدَخَلَ مَعَهُ السِّجْنَ فَتَيَانٍ. But now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that when Yusuf alayhi salam entered into prison, there were two other young men who were entered into prison along with him. قَالَ أَحَدُهُمَا إِنِّي أَرَانِي أَعْصِرُ خَمْرًا. They come to Yusuf alayhi salam and they say, look, we've heard that you're a special guy, that you can interpret dreams, that you're a very pious, righteous man. Well, one of them says, I saw a dream that I am basically squeezing, extracting wine for the king. وَقَالَ الْآخَرُ إِنِّي أَرَانِي أَحْمِلُ فَوْقَ رَأْسِي خُبْزًا تَأْكُلُ الطَّيْرُ مِنْهُ. And the second one says, I'm seeing that I'm carrying a basket of bread on my head, but what's going on is that these birds are coming and eating from that basket of bread. نَبِّئْنَا بِتَأْوِيلِهِ إِنَّا نَرَاكَ مِنَ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. So please tell us what these dreams mean, because we obviously see for ourselves, we heard, but now we see for ourselves that you are an excellent, excellent person. You are from those who excel in doing good deeds, a righteous, pious man. So now Yusuf alayhi salam does something very interesting. They're asking for the interpretation of their dreams. Yusuf alayhi salam says, this is the ideal opportunity to have a very important conversation. What does he say? قَالَ لَا يَأْتِيكُمَا طَعَامٌ تُرْزَقَانِهِ إِلَّا نَبَّأْتُكُمَا بِتَأْوِيلِهِ قَبْلَ أَن يَأْتِيَكُمَا. He says that, first of all, let me establish one thing. Before your next meal arrives, before lunch is served, I will have told you the interpretation of your dream. So meaning what? I'm not putting this off. I'm not brushing you off. I'm not trying to find a way out of this situation. I will tell you what your dreams mean, and I'll tell you, in fact, before lunch is served. So I need you to stay with me here. I need you to pay attention, because you want me, you're asking me for something. I'd like to share something with you as well. ذَلِكُمَا مِمَّا عَلَّمَنِي رَبِّي. He says, first of all, how do I interpret dreams? I'm not some angel that I interpret dreams. Rather, this is something my Lord, my Master, Allah taught me to do. إِنِّي تَرَكْتُ مِلَّةَ قَوْمٍ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ وَهُمْ بِالْآخِرَةِ هُمْ كَافِرُونَ. He says, I have left the religion, the way of those people who don't believe in Allah, and they disbelieve very vehemently in the life of the hereafter. They reject belief in the life of the hereafter. But rather, what do I do? What's my path in life? وَاتَّبَعْتُ مِلَّةَ آبَائِي إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَإِسْحَاقَ وَيَعْقُوبَ. He says, I follow the religion, the path of my forefathers, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, Ya'qub. مَا كَانَ لَنَا أَن نُشْرِكَ بِاللَّهِ مِنْ شَيْءٍ. That it is not fitting for us. It was never an option for us to ever associate anything with Allah as a partner. ذَلِكَ مِنْ فَضْلِ اللَّهِ عَلَيْنَا. This is from the huge blessing that Allah has showered upon us. وَعَلَى النَّاسِ, and upon people. وَلَكِنَّ أَكْثَرَ النَّاسِ لَا يَشْكُرُونَ. But rather, most people, they don't appreciate this fact that Allah has given us this information. Allah has taught us this. And then he says, يَا صَاحِبَيِ السِّجْنِ. Oh, my two companions in prison, my two buddies, my two prison mates. أَرْبَابٌ مُتَفَرِّقُونَ أَمْ أَرْبَابٌ مُتَفَرِّقُونَ خَيْرٌ أَمِ اللَّهُ الْوَاحِدُ الْقَهَارُ. He said, what's better? Is it better to worship many, many different deities and gods and lords? Or is it better to worship Allah, who is one, alone, unique, and dominant and powerful? Who do you think it's better to worship? What makes more sense to you? To worship these scattered lords and gods and idols that you don't even understand fully? Or to worship Allah, who is one, alone, unique, and almighty and all-powerful, and he's the one that's given me the gift that I'd like to share with y'all. مَا تَعْبُدُونَ مِن دُونِهِ إِلَّا أَسْمَاءٌ سَمَّيْتُمُهَا أَنْتُمْ وَآبَاؤُكُمْ مَا نَزَّلَ اللَّهُ بِهَا مِن سُلْطَانِ. He says, and as far as what you worship other than Allah, they're just names. These are just random ideas. These are fables. These are myths. These are names that you and your forefathers came up with. Allah never sent down anything that establishes this fact. ذَلِكَ, he says, إِنِ الْحُكْمُ إِلَّا لِلَّهِ, that the command, the power is only for Allah, is only in the hands of Allah. أَمَرَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّا. He has commanded that you worship no one other than Him, only Him you should worship. ذَلِكَ الدِّينُ الْقَيِّمُ. This is the proper way to live one's life. وَلَكِنَّ أَكْثَرَ النَّاسِ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. But most people, they don't understand. Now as Yusuf a.s. had promised, he says, يَا صَاحِبَيِ السِّجْنِ أَمَّا أَحَدُكُمَا فَيَسْقِي رَبَّهُ خَمْرًا. As for one of you, you will go back to serving wine to the king. وَأَمَّا الْآخَرُ فَيُصْلَبُ فَتَأْكُلُ الطَّيْرُ مِنْ رَأْسِ. And as for the other, you will be killed, you will be executed, and birds will come and peck away at your head after you are dead, after you have been hung. قُضِيَ الْأَمْرُ الَّذِي فِيهِ تَسْتَفْتِيَانِ. And that's exactly what ended up happening with the two people that asked the question to Yusuf alayhi salam. So this is a very interesting story from the life of Yusuf alayhi salam. This is an amazing event from his life, from his story that's told to us in the Quran. Why did I choose to share this story with y'all today? And why did I say that this had a profound impact on me? Let me explain. Yusuf alayhi salam is a prophet of Allah. He is a caller and inviter to Allah. That's what he does. Now he's found himself in a bit of a predicament. He was dealing with some serious circumstances which lead to him in being in prison. But he does not let that stand in the way of him living out the potential, the purpose of his life. He does not let that get in the way of his identity, who he is, the purpose of his life. He is a prophet of God. He is a prophet of Allah. He invites people to Allah. So if he's out in the open, if he's free, if he's in the free, if he's living at home, he invites people to Allah. But if he is locked up in prison, he still invites people to Allah. And then a couple of quick tips for that person doing some work of da'wah, talking to people, trying to invite people to Allah. A couple of tips we pick up from Yusuf alayhi salam, a prophet of Allah. Number one, look for the opportune time. When you have people's attention, when you are sitting and conversing with people, exchanging thoughts and ideas with people, and that's when you go in. That's when you try to, you know, that's when you basically share this message with them. The second thing is that Yusuf alayhi salam doesn't just abstractly talk about Allah, but what does he do? Yusuf alayhi salam connects the idea of Allah, the message about Allah, to their actual question. They're saying, you're an amazing guy, you can interpret dreams. He says, yeah, well, where do you think this comes from? Allah gave me this gift. He connects it to the situation. He seizes the situation when he has their attention. And thirdly, and most importantly, he keeps his word. He's a man of his word. He told them, I will tell you what your dream means before lunch is served. And what happened? He told them what their dreams meant before lunch was served. And whether they believed or not, it was on them. So, an inspiration that I take from the story of Yusuf alayhi salam, remember who you are. You're a Muslim. Wherever you go, no matter what the circumstances are, what they're saying on the news, what the Islamophobes are saying, or whatever's going on, you are a Muslim. Believe that, know that, live your life as a Muslim. And as a Muslim, it is your responsibility to share the message of Islam with all of mankind. Tell people, introduce people, call people to Allah. People deserve to know who Allah is. Share the message about Allah with them. But when you do so, remember to be a man of integrity like Yusuf alayhis salam. I hope everyone benefited from today's lesson, from stories of the prophets. Inshallah, I'll see y'all next time. Jazakumullahu khairan. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. At this point, I've pretty much given up all hope of actually making it back home, so I decided I would just record a couple of more sessions while I am out here before it gets dark. I'm afraid there actually might be bears over here, so I need y'all to keep me in your du'as, inshallah.